apply. In this video, we're going to look at an application of quadratic equations using everybody's favorite pastime, Angry Birds. So you see here I have a screen capture from the game where I've already flung my bird into the air, and it's quickly approaching the ground. The white dots show you the path that the bird has followed. If you look at that, you see it's a parabola, or at least part of a parabola, which means it can be modeled by or represented with a quadratic function. So before we look at the actual equation, let's look at how this parabola fits on sort of an xy axis. First off, we have our y axis. We're going to draw that right here where the bird is starting at the slingshot, sort of our initial part. This is our y-axis. The x-axis for this problem is going to represent the ground. Of course, our bird is never actually going to hit the ground. Hopefully, it's going to hit some egg-stealing pigs so that we win this level and move on. Now here, our lovely parabola has some basic features. First off, the initial value, the y-intercept. The x-intercept would be where it hits the ground, but neither of those are what we want to look for in this problem. What we want to know is what the maximum height was. So how high did it get up here? To do that, we're going to need a model, an equation that represents this function. And it is going to be a quadratic one because this is a parabola. So the function that we're going to have is f of x equals negative 0.2x squared plus 8x plus 9. For this problem, you do notice that our leading coefficient is negative, negative 0.2, x squared. X squared tells us this is a parabola, and that negative leading coefficient tells us that the parabola opens down, so our vertex will be a maximum, meaning it'll look just like the one we have up above. For this problem, f is the height of the bird. And we want to find the maximum height. Here, x is not time, but is the distance in feet from the original position, meaning from the slingshot. So the distance from its starting point. Meaning, let me change colors here for a second so we can see it on the drawing. If we wanted to know what this point represented, you notice I am a distance this way of x, and at that distance from my starting point, I am up a height right here of f of x. So f represents the height when we are a distance x away from the starting point from the slingshot. So what we want to know is what this height is way up here when we're up at our vertex, which means we need to find the vertex for this equation. So since I'm out of room, let me pan up. We'll come back to our drawing in a few minutes. But this is the equation we need, and we're going to use the formula to find the vertex where the x part of this point is equal to negative b over 2a. And this b and a represent the coefficients in the original problem. First off, before we start assigning anything, you want to make sure that you have your quadratic in descending order or in a standard form. So the first term is the x squared, the second one is the x, and the last one is the constant. That's what we have here. Since we have that, we can just go ahead and assign each of these coefficients to the variables. A is always the first one, so negative 0.2. B, the middle one, so 8. And C, the constant at the end, 9. So we're going to go ahead and plug these into our formula to see that the x part of the vertex is a point, so remember it has these two parts. The x part is going to be equal to negative b, which is 8, over 2 times negative 0.2. So we're going to go ahead and simplify that amount out, being careful with the negatives, making sure everything cancels out the way we want it. And we get that x is equal to 20. So going back up to my original problem for a second, the drawing that we have here, we know that when we get to this vertex, this maximum part here, we have traveled a horizontal distance of 20 feet. That's what the x represents in the problem. Now we want to actually answer the question I asked you, which is what is the maximum height, not when does it occur. So we go back to our x and continue from there. So let me go back to the work that we were doing down here. We got that x is equal to 20, and in this problem that means 20 feet. But to find out what the corresponding y is, what the corresponding height is, means we want to just take this value and plug it in. So we want to find f of 20, set x equal to 20, and go from there. So we're going to have negative 0.2 times 20 squared plus 8 times 20 plus 9. If we go ahead and type this into a calculator and simplify, we're going to find that f of 20, the corresponding output that goes with 20 feet as an input, is 89 feet. So back to our original problem here in the drawing. We know when we've gone a distance of 20 feet from the slingshot, we get a height here of 89 feet. And that's our answer. The vertex for this problem, this point, is the point 2089. But the solution to the problem is that the maximum height is 89 feet. Well, I hope this helps you solve application problems, and frankly, I hope it helps you play Angry Birds.